Award-winning journalist Yvonne Ridley is well known in the Muslim world for her outspoken opposition to Zionism, criticism of Western media, and defense of Islam. She was born on 23rd of April 1958 in England. Being a teenager, she was eager to be a journalist in a way that her mother described her as hungry for news.
Wherever she was, if anything cropped up, she'd be there, you know, hungry for news.
Consequently, she wrote to every newspaper group in the UK. At the age of 16, she was able to attend a journalism course at London College Printing. Since then, she started working as a journalist at different papers, like the Sunday Times, the Independent on Sunday, the Observer, the Mirror, the News of the World, and so on. The most outstanding point in her life is her captivity by the Taliban and her conversion to Islam. On the 28th of September 2001, she was arrested by the Taliban while she was working for the Sunday Express. She entered Afghanistan without a visa, dressed like an Afghan woman. She was taken to Jalalabad for further investigation on possible espionage charges. Her interrogation took 10 days, causing her to miss her daughter's 9th birthday. According to what she said, while she was in captivity, she was asked by one of her captors to convert to Islam. She refused but promised to read the Quran after her release. She kept her word and read the Holy Quran, and it changed her life, and eventually she converted to Islam in summer of 2003. Yvonne Ridley has written two books called In the Hands of the Taliban and Ticket to Paradise. She's a founder member of Stop the War Coalition, and also she joined Free Gaza Movement in 2008. In her spare time, Yvonne travels throughout the UK and across the globe, promoting peace and the anti-war message. In an interview with BBC News, she was asked about the place of women in Islam, and she answered, "There are oppressed women in Muslim countries, but I can take you up the side streets of Tenasite and show you oppressed women there. Oppression is cultural, it is not Islamic. The Quran makes it crystal clear that women are equal." Now she is the member of the great family of Islam, and she said, "I have joined what I consider to be the biggest and best family in the world. When we stick together, we are absolutely invincible."
I refuse to bow down to anyone but God.